powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
This is the day the Lord has made. Oh, rejoice and be glad. You're welcome to pray and prophesy to your day. I believe that God's word has all it takes to reposition our way of thinking and to inspire us to take the lead in the direction of His will. God's intention for you is to bring you into a place of fulfilling your destiny, into a place of doing something strategic with the gift of life, with everything that God has entrusted to your care. You've been called to make a difference. You've been called to take the lead. You've been called to be a person of positive influence and manifest the God life. As we begin to pray and prophesy to our day, expect preferential treatment. Expect supernatural increase. You know, God is a God of supernatural increase. Often, He wants to bring us into increasing increase. He wants you to see increase on every side. So today we're saying God will show you what to do. You know, sometimes people go through situations and circumstances of life and they don't know what to do. But God will show you what to do. You see, when you know what to do, it helps you in your decision making. It helps you to function in the direction of the will of God. He shows you what to do because He has a great plan for your dreams. He has a great plan for your life. He's more interested in revealing His will to you. God doesn't want us to walk in darkness or to stumble in blackness or to live a life that is not consistent with His plan. This is His will, a life of abundance, a life of prosperity, a life of supernatural increase. He will show you what to do when you submit to the leadership of His Spirit. You know, one of the ways that God shows us what to do is when we submit to the leadership of His Spirit. The Spirit of God has the master plan of heaven for your life, for your dream, for your business, for your relationship, for your career. And when you trust in the Spirit's leadership, in the leadership of the Spirit, you come into a place of influence. You come into a place of greater possibilities when you learn to trust the leadership of the Spirit. You know, it takes the leadership of the Spirit for we to be productive in our God-given calling. Whatever the calling may be, whether it's in business or in ministry or to serve in a local assembly or whatever the calling may be, when we trust in the leadership of the Spirit, amazing things begin to happen. And you are those viewing this broadcast today. God will show you what to do when you choose to think from the perspective of His word. He will show you what to do. When you choose to think from the perspective of His word, He will reveal to you what to do. What to do about the job, what to do about the relationship. God is more willing to reveal to you what He wants you to do than what you want to do. He's more willing to reveal to you what He wants you to do in this season. Concerning your job, concerning your finances, concerning your career, concerning your assignment, God will show you what to do. And if you have a revelation of His will, nothing can be impossible to you. Can I say this to you? He knows what you will do that will move you to the next level of your life. And the key to unlocking that is obedience to His will. Obedience to the will of God. You see, if we choose the path of His will, we're going to live above obstacle, above limitation, above the challenges of life. If we choose the path of His will, and that can only happen when we choose to walk in obedience. Those who walk in obedience will always be fruitful in all season. Those who walk in obedience, and God wants you to walk in obedience. No matter what is happening right now in your job, in your finances, in your career, God wants you to walk in obedience. He wants you to trust Him. Trust Him with your future. Trust Him with your job. Trust Him with your life. It doesn't matter what is going on right now. There is a great future ahead of you. It doesn't matter how you feel about the situation. There is victory in Jesus. There is victory in Jesus. There is healing in Jesus. There is deliverance in Jesus. There is a miracle, signs, and wonder in Jesus. And this is why the scripture said, the just shall live by his faith. You know why? Because faith in God never fail. Often I say to my viewers that those who walk by faith, nothing will be impossible to them. Because true faith in God will always focus on God's word. True faith in God will always focus on God's word. And God is saying to us today, He wants to show us what to do. But we need to submit to His Spirit. We need to abide in His word. We need to walk in obedience. Submission to the Spirit, abiding in the word, walking in obedience. These are three strategic principles that helps us to receive from God. Submit to the leadership of the Spirit. Abide in the word of God. Walk in obedience. It's so important that we begin to understand the power that we release when we walk in obedience. When you walk in obedience, it doesn't matter what the situation may be or what the circumstances may be. When you choose the path of obedience, you have chosen the path of greatness. In Deuteronomy 28 verse 1, Deuteronomy 28 verse 1, it said, if you hearken to the voice of the Lord your God, He said, He will set you on high. If you will hearken, if you will respond, if you will stand on the word of God, He said He will set you on high above all the nations of the earth. So obedience is the key to promotion. If you're going to be promoted supernaturally, it's because you chose the path of walking in obedience. You know, sometimes people say, well, I'm not seeing the kind of result I want to see. I'm not having the kind of harvest I need to have. But the question right now is, are you doing what God asked you to do? Are you doing it how He wants you to do it? Are you doing it according to the instruction that was entrusted to your care? Are you doing it for the purpose of glorifying God? You see, your way of thinking has a lot to do with the manifestation and the experience you're going to have. Your way of thinking. And so God wants us to walk in His will. God wants us to prosper in purpose. God wants us to excel in life. But we can't truly excel if we don't submit to the leadership of the Spirit, if we don't abide in the word of God, if we don't walk in obedience. You have to submit to the leadership of the Spirit. Romans 8 verse 14, he said, as many that are led by the Spirit of God, he said, they are the sons of God. And he said, abide in me. John 15 verse 4, abide in me and I in you. He said, if the word of God does not abide in us, we cannot produce the God kind of result. You can only produce the God kind of result and live supernaturally in this natural world. Because when we live supernaturally in this natural world, it helps us to have dominion, to dominate circumstances and situations, because we chose the path of supernatural living. And that happened when we walk in the revelation of the Christ in us. You see, because Christ lives in me, that is the fountain of the supernatural living. Christ in me is the fountain of supernatural living. Because Christ is in me, I will rise beyond every obstacle and challenges of life. God wants to show you what to do. So you got to submit to the leadership of the Spirit. Number two, you got to abide in the word of God. Number three, you got to walk in obedience. These are strategic keys to you to step into amazing favor, step into amazing opportunity, walk in preferential treatment, walk in supernatural favor, because you chose the path of obedience. He said you will know the truth and the truth will make you free. But let me say this to us. It is the application of the truth that makes us free. We got to apply the word of God to the situation. It doesn't matter what the situation is right now. If you can apply God's word to the situation, this situation is subject to change. The situation is subject to change right now, and you can walk in supernatural result. You can walk in supernatural favor. You can walk in preferential treatment when you choose the path of obedience. Oh, let's begin to praise the name of the Lord. This is pray and prophesy to your day. I was just giving a brief charge, but let's begin to pray in the spirit. In the name of Jesus, there is a miracle that happens when we choose to trust God. God wants to show you what to do. I'd like us to begin to pray right now that we'll receive revelation of the will of the Father in the direction of our present need. We'll receive the revelation of the will of the Father in the direction of our present need. So whatever our present need is right now, we're going to receive the revelation of the Father. Lift up your voice right now. Let's begin to pray. We'll receive the revelation of the Father. We'll receive revelation to move in the direction of the will of God. We'll receive revelation to operate in the greater things of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Right now we're going to pray that we're going to walk in the light of what God has revealed to us. You know, sometimes God could reveal something to a person, but they're not consistent in walking in that direction. They're not consistent in walking in the direction of what God has revealed to them. You see, God is interested in showing you His will, showing you His plan. But sometimes a lot of people can't step into the plan of God. They can't step into the purpose of God because of their inability to stay focused, to walk in patience. So we're going to pray right now, Lord, help me to stick with your plan. Help me to stick with the process. Help me to stick with your will. Lord, help me to stick with your plan. Lord, help me to stick with your will. Lord, I stick to your plan. It is when you stick to his plan that you flourish in purpose. It is when you stick to his plan that your focus begins to produce results. Lord, I stick to your plan. Lord, I stick to your purpose. In this month we have started right now, somebody needs to be committed to the plan of God. Somebody needs to be committed to the will of God. You can't be going here and there trying to know from people what God is saying about your life. You got to stay in the word. You got to be praying the Holy Ghost and the Spirit of God to begin to reveal the will of the Father. Rindo In the name of Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, glory be to God. As we pray in the spirit, we release greater things into the atmosphere. There is something that happens to us when we begin to pray in tongue. We begin to pray the future unknowing to us. So many people want to see greater release. They want to see greater manifestation. Let's begin to pray right now that there will be a mighty outpouring of the Spirit in every dimension of our vision. A mighty outpouring of the Spirit. Mighty manifestation. Mighty visitation of the Spirit. Mbredes ke torambro sokotoli kababa, riketeli kaparato seketoli baba. Mighty manifestation of the Spirit, mighty release of the Holy Ghost, mighty outpouring of the Spirit of God. We say ke terebo sakari korobo se terebo. Mbredes ke torambro des ke torambro sokopariko, likama sukata le kotora pose tereba. Mbredes ke kotora des ke kaparado seketoli kababa. Mighty release of the Spirit in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. We're going to pray against distraction. One of the greatest weapons of Satan that he uses against God's people most of the time is deception and distraction. You see, these are major weapons of the enemy. Deception and distraction. So let's begin to bind every form of deception. Makurata, makurata, makurata. Pede koto keto 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 keto. Mbrede ketedakrato se ketoribaba. Every spirit of deception will bind in the name of Jesus. We take authority against deception, against lying spirit, against distraction. We bind it in the name of Jesus. I decree right now, supernatural help from above, supernatural release from above. Me kondorobo sakandara baba, rekotoli paparado seketoli baba, pedeketeke paprato seketori kapaba, retete repo seketori kaparato, mekete rato setorobo sataraba, mbrede seketori posotori kapaba, rato sokoparato baba. We bind deception, we bind extraction, we bind every lying spirit, every demonic conspiracy. We come against it in the name of Jesus. I come against every demonic conspiracy. Whatever that is trying to cause distraction in your mind, in your soul, around you, I bind that spirit right now and I cast it out in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Listen to this. God revealed things to us because he wants us to be responsible for it. I say God revealed things to us because he wants us to be responsible for it. One of the reasons why God revealed things to us is that he wants us to be responsible for it. You see, when God gives you a revelation, it's because he wants you to accept the responsibility of acting on the revelation he has release towards your direction. We're going to pray right now for the ability to be sensitive to everything entrusted to our care. You know, some people are not sensitive to the will of God. They are not sensitive to who God has connected them to. They are not sensitive. I was talking to some people in our local church yesterday. I said, one of the worst things that can happen to you in life is to miss your prophetic moment. Is to miss the moment that God has put in place to change your life. That is one of the worst regrets a man can have, is to miss his prophetic moment. Moments that are supposed to move him forward. Moments that are supposed to alleviate him from struggle, from toiling, and from hard labor. So let's begin to pray right now. I'm not going to miss my prophetic moment. Whatever moment that God has put in my way that will help me to get to my next level, whatever relationship, whatever he has put around me that will help me to facilitate the dream, let's begin to pray right now. Kurande rebo shanda baba, kurande borobo shanda baba. Kurande bobo shekendo baba, kurande rebo seketori baba, kurande seketondiri kambara baba, kurande seketoli kabra baba, lo shikata rato seketoli kababa, rindo robo sakatali baba. In the name of Jesus, I will not miss my prophetic moments. I will not miss the moments that connect me with my great destiny. Boyasha katali kabra doske torate setobo, menia tatantoli kabra doske to, elakuka tekete protoske torada san. Santalaba, Leka Krudoske Torika Pradeske Tolika Parato, Meleka Toloseke Telibaba, divine connection, divine arrangement, divine open doors, Lekorika Talaba, Meneka Toleka Torapan Sotolekaba, Meloko Prato Seke Torato Tataparito, Meneka Kolato Tanto Takapanto Seka, Likorito Sotorika Paniata, Menokonina Sakunkarapa, Kroto Seketeni Katakatina na Patinopo, Mentonto Panditampanto Parato Sentorikaba, Briduske Toraka Likoruba Sotobaba. In the name of Jesus, my path is crossing with the right people. My path is crossing with the right people. In the name of Jesus, the right men and women, the right boys and girls, the right businessmen, the right businesswomen, the right ministers of the gospel, Borodo Setori Baba Baba, the doors are opening in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. God wants to show you something in this season that will change the landscape of your ministry. Somebody, you're watching me right now, you have been battling with what the Lord asked you to do because you're not getting the kind of result you want to get. You're battling with what the Lord has called you to do. You've been battling with it. You've been struggling with it. Listen to this. Great things begins with a small potential. It starts small, then grow big. You can't start it big, but you got to start it from what God is saying to you. God always give people beginning. God always give people humble beginning. He always give people humble beginning. Humble beginning in ministry, humble beginning in business, humble beginning in different areas of life. God always give people humble beginning. He always wants to do that. And God is saying to us right now, I am giving you humble beginning. Whatever God is asking you to do, don't put it aside because of your need for finances or because of what people feel or think about it. The most important person to obey in your life is to obey God. If you can obey God, you will secure your destiny. You will secure your dream. You will secure your future. Going to secure your dream. Everything you need to secure is in obedience. You know, I just want to say this to someone watching me today. Don't give up because people never endorse your assignment. Don't give up because of those you look up to could not support you. Don't give up because those you felt would have given you all the help walked away. You see, if God have asked you to do something, He doesn't want you to rely on opinion to do it. He wants you to rely on the leading of His Spirit to act on it. You see, you don't become successful by opinion. You become successful by listening to the Spirit of God. Opinion may be good, but opinion may not be the perfect will of God. But if you're led by the Spirit, you will be more profitable. You'll be more effective. You'll be more successful. You'll be more great if you're led by the Spirit of God. You know, I used to say to people, if God have asked you to do something, stop trying to listen to everybody. That is what brings confusion. What brings confusion is that you walk to this apostle today, next tomorrow you walk with this prophet, next tomorrow you're here. You are bringing so much confusion into your life. Get one person you could trust his counsel, you could trust the God in them, and align yourself with them. You can't be prostituting with the anointing. You can't be hopping from place to place. You got to sit one place and do the word of God. This is how you make profits. This is how you prosper. This is how you become successful. A lot of people are jumping all over the place. Today they go to this place, they hear this. Next morning they listen to this. Next, you know, they are confused. There are a lot of Christians right now that are so confused, they don't know what to do. The reason they don't know what to do is that they are listening to too many voices. They are listening to too many people at the same time. They listen to this person, they listen to this prophetess, they listen to this person. They are confused right now. They don't really know who to listen to. He said, my sheep will hear my voice and they will follow. And the voice of a stranger, they will not follow. The voice of a stranger, they will not follow. If you are truly going to fulfill the call of God in your life, if you are truly going to fulfill the will of God concerning your life, you must learn to pay attention to covenant relationship. There are relationships we call covenant relationship. What do we call them? We call them covenant relationship. They are relationships that God brought you into. They are people that God brought into your life to build you up. Covenant relationship, you don't find them everywhere. Somebody can be your next door neighbor and you don't have a good relationship with them. But somebody can be in Atlanta and you are in Jamaica or you are in Brazil, but both of you have a very solid relationship. So relationship is no longer built on proximity right now. Relationship is built on divine connection. Can I connect with her? Can I connect with him? Can we do things together? Can we connect together? So that somebody is my next door neighbor does not mean we're going to have a relationship. But somebody can be in North America and both of us are talking either on WhatsApp or we're talking through Facebook or we're talking through the email and we have a strong relationship, because when it comes to destiny, your spirit must pick it up. I said, when it comes to destiny, your spirit must pick it up. This is why God puts us in covenant relationship. Covenant relationship are relationship that empowers us to accelerate to the new dimension of what God wants us to experience. And I'm praying for you right now that you will not miss the covenant relationship that God has put in your life. Because covenant relationships are the pillars that hold the dream of your future. Those are the strategic pillars that sustain your assignment, that sustains your calling. Covenant relationship. Relationships with destiny. Relationship with destiny. This is what makes your life successful. This is why some people keep rising. They are not rising because they pray more or because they are more intelligent, but because they know how to maximize covenant connections. Covenant connections. They know who God has called them to. They know who God has called them to. They know who God has called into their life, and they know who they are called to. Can I say this to you? If you are going to receive more from God, if you want God to show you things, you must learn to maximize covenant relationship. Look at David and Jonathan. David and Jonathan, covenant relationship. Covenant relationship, covenant connection that produced supernatural acceleration. Look at David and Jonathan. They were in a covenant tie. And because of that covenant relationship, Saul was not able to kill David. Because everything Saul would do, Jonathan would reveal it to David. That is a covenant connection. In a covenant connection, this person has your back and you have their back, because it's a covenant connection. There is no betrayal that exists there. There is no manipulation. One of the greatest gifts you will ever receive from God. Listen to this, people of God. After you have received Jesus, you have received the Holy Ghost, you have received the gifts of the Spirit, power of God, all those things. The greatest gift you will ever receive after that time is a covenant relationship. Most people are not real. We have a lot of fake ministers, fake apostles. We have so many fake prophets, fake people. You see, we have fake brethren, people that are not true to what they say, people that are not. So one of the greatest blessings you're going to have this season is a covenant relationship. Somebody who could look at you and tell you the truth. Somebody who could look at you and say, baby, that's not right. That's not scriptural. Somebody can look at you and tell you, baby, that is not in line with God's word. You can't hang around that fellow that way. Somebody can look at you and say, I perceive you've just missed it. Because the fruit begins to show, the evidence begins to show, and this person begins to tell you that you have missed it. And look at you boldly and say, I don't think that what you're doing is right. You see, most time we don't have those kind of connections because we don't want to be in a relationship where someone could look at us and say, hey, that thing you did is not scriptural. Covenant relationships are the very foundation of building a strategic future. Building a great future, building an outstanding future. I pray for you this morning, wherever you're watching this broadcast from, that God will connect you. I don't care whether it's going to be on Facebook, I don't care whether it's going to be on WhatsApp, I don't care whether it's going to be on Instagram, I don't care whether it's going to be on Periscope, that these people connect with you and they started building great ministry, great business with you, great things with you. Covenant connection sustains great visions. I said, covenant connections sustains great vision. If your vision must be sustained, there has to be covenant connection. And I pray for you right now, because in covenant connection, you receive inspiration, you receive encounter. Covenant relationships are resources for building a great future. This is what makes some people successful, not because they knew everything, but because the person they have covenants with have some revelation, have some inspiration, have some apostolic grace upon his life, and begin to push them into their destiny. Every one of us needs someone that can push us into our destiny. Every one of us needs someone that can look at us and say, hey, I feel like God is doing this around you. Someone that can affirm some things around you. Someone that can look at you and speak into your life. And these are strategic pillars of success. These are strategic keys of success. If you truly want to succeed in ministry, if you truly want to succeed in life, there are people that God has put you and them together. Know your team. Know your team. Know who God has connected you and them together. Know who you are running with. Know whose future is connected to yours. Know whose gifting is connected to yours. Know whose anointing is connected to yours. Know whose grace is connected to yours. Know whose vision is connected to yours. And when you begin to understand it, something amazing begins to happen, because there is a covenant connection. Covenant connection brings covering. Covenant connection brings strength. There is someone watching this broadcast right now, and the Spirit of God is saying, you have lost your covenant connection. Reconnect back with them. Reconnect back with her. Reconnect back with him. Go back to your covenant connection. Connections of destiny. Connections of purpose. Connections that strengthen you. Don't let offense ruin what God is building. Don't let offense destroy. One of the things that destroy covenant connection is offense, bitterness, hatred, malice, unforgiveness. Those things can attack covenant connections. You're watching this broadcast right now, and the Spirit of God is saying, it's time to make a difference. It's time to go to the next level. It's time to go to the next dimension. It's time to go. God wants to show you what to do. God wants to put people around you. I pray for you right now that every covenant connection you need to go to the next dimension of your ministry, the next dimension of relationship, the next dimension of your job, the next dimension, may they manifest right now. May they begin to come to you. May they show up in your life. May they come to you right now. I decree and I declare there'll be a divine alignment in the spirit that will change everything around you. Thank you, Father, for the covenant connections. Thank you, Father, for revealing what we should do. Thank you, Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus. If you're watching this broadcast right now and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I'd like you to repeat this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God have raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray this prayer with us, it means you're born again, and the Spirit of God is going to help you fulfill your purpose. So I want to also encourage you to go to finishworktv.com and keep watching us in finishworktv.com. Finishworktv.com is an online TV that is empowering so many people today around the world. So we encourage you to go to finishworktv.com. Watch it every day. There is so much messages that will inspire you to take the lead in the direction of God's will. We also want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Over 1,000 videos right now on YouTube with so much revelation and inspiration that will change you. So go to Faithman Teaching on YouTube and subscribe, as you consistently receive messages when the new videos are released. I want to say this to you. We love you, and we're investing into your future with these teachings of God's word. And also, you can reach out to me on Facebook. You can be my friend on Facebook. It's Faithman Ogboada or Faithman Ogboada Ministry. Who can be friends, who can build a covenant relationship to make a difference in these last days and change the lives of people all over the world. I also want to encourage you to consider partnering with this ministry. Partnership helps me to be able to bring this message to many people around the world. Partnership is strategic in moving the gospel forward. When Jesus wanted to preach, he said to Peter, "Can I have your boat?" And Peter gave his boat. That was partnership. And when it was done, he said to Peter, "Launch into the deep." So partnership is strategic. Our partners are those who pray for us often and those who can give any financial support as the Spirit of God leads them to be a blessing to the ministry. Thank you for watching this broadcast. Until I come your way soon, because I'm coming back soon, until I come your way soon, don't ever forget this. There is greatness in you.